I just thought we were victorious. We had three targets in our campaign in the last month or so. One was to try and stop them cutting the tax credits. We think we've done that, as I've welcomed that, but we've still found in the detail that families may lose out about $3 billion in the next few years. So we're going to check that detail, but we're claiming quite a victory on that. Our second target was our campaign to prevent the police cuts, which we thought would be a disaster in the face of the terrorist threat at the moment. And we think we've reversed that completely. But again, we'll look at the detail of that. The third area was social care. And what the Chancellor's done there is he's allowed local authorities to increase council tax with a precept of 2%. Now, I don't think we've completely won on that one, because that will only actually tackle half of the deficit that they're facing. And also some local authorities may not be able to raise that precept. So we're claiming victory on most of the campaigns we've waged. So I'm quite pleased with that. It wasn't taking the wind out of us. In fact, we were congratulating him to a certain extent.
Do you see that? Do you think that's going to be how it's portrayed and seen, that it's a great victory for the Labour opposition rather than rather a sharp piece of political manoeuvring from the Chancellor?
Well, to be honest, I'm not bothered whether it's a sharp piece of manoeuvring or not by him. A few weeks ago, it's only 3 weeks ago, you know, these tax credit cuts were going through. We campaigned against them. We mobilised. We linked up with Conservative backbench MPs. We linked up with the House of Lords. Our MPs have been campaigning right the way throughout the country in their constituencies, and we've been sending people into campaigning Conservative constituencies as well. And it's worked. And I celebrate that, but I'm still a bit worried. I said in my speech, the devil is always in the detail of this. I'm still a bit worried because we think we've identified that there may be $3 billion still being cut from families. So we'll look at that and we'll have to go back and start campaigning again.
Do you think perhaps, sir, the danger is that the abiding image of today will not be what you're claiming as a great victory for your party in opposition, but an image of you waving around Mao's little red book, which seems to have been seen by even members of the Labour Party as a bit of a blunder?
No, it wasn't a blunder. What I was trying to do, I've been ribbing the Conservatives about what they've been doing in terms of selling off our assets. And today, they've brought forward another $5 billion of, well, our assets, the people's assets for sale. And I've been ribbing them about how much has actually been going to, well, to China, how much the Chinese government has been buying. And this is a contradiction here that the government has. It seems to want to enable the Chinese state to nationalise many of our assets, but at the same time, it won't do anything about allowing the British government to either bring something into public ownership or invest. So I wanted to try and get that across. And as I say, I've been ribbing them and try to get across in a bit of a humorous way. It's certainly drawn attention to those sales.
Holding Mao Zedong up as a great role model.
No, not at all. But what I wanted to do is put George Osborne on the spot, because he's been the big advocate of selling resources to foreign states. And that's actually affecting now our balance of payments even, because a lot of the resources we're selling off, other states are gaining income from it, and we're losing as a result.
John McDonald, thank you for talking to us.